You're listening to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast with your host, T. Penzel. Enjoy.
Hold on. Alarms
on. Bro, she got both phones in her hand. Hold on. You Gucci? Everybody good?
No, I'm Fendi.
I love it. Hey, I love that for you. How are you feeling today? Are you Prada? Saint Laurent, right here. What's going on, your boy T. Fidel? Welcome back to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast. I am your host. It's good to be back. Hope everybody's doing well. Happy April.
Happy April.
Yeah,
you said happy. Happy. I meant happy.
Okay, it's March.
Why you ain't gotta say that when they see this? When they see it, it's gonna be April.
Oh.
She want me on this shit. Let me just say, it's March 30th, guys. So it ain't like it's March 10th and I'm just gonna hold on to this shit.
I just want y'all to know it's that my birthday is coming up. Okay.
Come on.
April, baby.
Happy birthday. What does that make you? Your zodiac sign? Too,
yeah. It doesn't matter what's about that bullshit.
That's crazy.
It's all right. Whatever. Aries, all the Aries folks outside this month, happy birthday to y'all. Real quick, this is the viral video online. And you know, he reacted to it because he's hostile and short-tempered and has a lot of other things going on. Starting down at the end, would you take $250 in food stamps or or dinner with Soulja Boy? Like, you know what I mean? You know how people be like, oh, $1 million with dinner with Jay-Z, but you can get some information. Which one are you going to do?
Okay. Speaking to the mic, I'm definitely gonna take the $250, but Soulja Boy, don't come for me. I still do your dance, but I'm taking the food stamps.
Soulja
Boy,
the you.
Yeah, I'm like you all over the apartment and stuff. So like, I still fuck with you and everything, but like.
But you're taking that $250.
Yeah, I'm taking the $250.
Okay, that's.
I mean, $250 ain't much. Obviously, that's my minimum for tattoos. So I mean, I'll take he have to eat vegan. So, I mean, I'll take that. You know, we can hang out. You know, we can roll up.
You might get some information.
I mean, yeah. I mean, first of all, let's not get it twisted. He started all the little social media dancing and all that stuff. If it wasn't for him, none of it would have. We've been cranking none of that. So,
she gave you your props, Soulja. You were first, Soulja.
He was first.
You started this shit.
I remember that Batman. Wait, no, not Batman.
Superman or who?
No, but Batman came after that. But
they did one for everyone. Lion King, they did one for like everything you can think of.
My shit was always hot. That little dance shit was cool, but nothing beat the Hot About the Bed to my swag.
Oh my gosh.
That shit was so good.
Hot About the Bed. Nah, that kiss you to the phone shit was weak.
No, I do. Like, it was corny.
So niggas was. Nigga was kissing you to the phone?
I mean, now looking back, it's very, very corny. Would kiss me through, like,
but it was like the time of the ringtone, so that was super popular.
Girl, you know I got something.
Yeah, all right. It was angry but sweet. Myra,
I'll take the convo with Soulja Boy. You know, Soulja Boy is lit, man. Like, you gotta think about it. Remember, like years ago. Remember when 50 Cent had that club in the club? Song in the club. I'm excited, y'all.
When the hell was that? That shit was.
Yeah, but then Soulja Boy had made a song entitled the same thing, and then everybody who was trying to find 50 Cent's song was finding Soulja Boy's song. So it's like, he's kind of like a marketing genius, if you really think about
it. Oh, yes, 100%.
And I would love to have a combo and just, you know, pick his brain a little bit.
Combo and a dessert. You know,
he's still doing his thing. He be on TikTok live and stuff.
Like, he's still doing his thing. He be on TikTok.
He do it. Don't do that.
Yeah.
He be on TikTok live, interacting with the fans and stuff. So, yeah, I have a combo. I could probably just get on TikTok and have a combo with him on live, right?
Yeah, he be on live all the time, baby. Just at the house on live.
So I should just I need to go follow him so I can get on his live.
He funny. Follow Soulja Boy. Soulja Boy, I'm going to take the combo as well, man. I'm going to take the combo just to chop it up.
Right.
I know I'm going to get a couple laughs out of the situation. I'm going to ask you about old school hoes like Cash Stacks.
Oh my god.
Where's Cash Stacks at? Yeah. Shout out to all the old school people that's getting us through the time. Cash Stacks, 50 Tyson.
I learned that name in a minute.
Yeah, Cash Stacks. Blah. She was the first one like really exposing them, boy.
She was a problem. Even Young Jeezy sending a song, Dirty White. Yeah, that's Cash Stacks. Like, she was a problem. She was definitely
probably was a problem. I thought she used to work at South Beach at like one of the the little towel shops, like when you buy baby suits or towel. Really? She's working on South Beach, yeah. And she blew it when got them little meows done. And then she got them bitties done. And she put little tattoos on it. And she was off.
Oh. And they Cast ate it that up.
Documentary coming
they
soon.
They ate it up, boy. I bet she got a story to tell for everybody. Oh,
she definitely got some stories.
Like, too bad.
Yeah, she got a book on it. She got a book. So how y'all feel about the TikTok ban? You think it's happening?
Are they really doing it?
That's I don't think,
Do you think it's happening.
Happening?
It's happen?
No.
I hope it do.
What?
I hope it do because she y'all want to ban my page because I'm beautiful and black.
She hurt.
She's yeah, so because they said that I was showing nudity when I wasn't. But
what you
got
a nipple?
No. But there's probably these other females with less color in my in their skin than mine, and they are on there in their bikinis shaking everything. But I have on a shirt and my swimsuit, and I get banned.
What you showed on there?
Nothing. I was literally sitting down. I had a shirt on, and I had my swimsuit on. And I was sitting down.
The like, thing literally, hanging. You couldn't. That, thing, that cat
the
was
key,
hanging on.
No, yeah. You have to be by a beach or a pool.
No, you have to, what?
You have to be by a beach or a pool, and if you want to wear a swimsuit.
Wait. I was. Yeah, that's the thing.
She ran into the room.
Dang.
I was. That's the thing.
They really got you feet. Then.
That's what I'm saying. I was.
Buying that. So you
didn't
fight it?
I did, and
they
still...
Lost.
TikTok banned my page. By
your shit got banned too? What y'all been doing?
No, like, it was just, I posted a video, and it was literally, I didn't violate anything, so when I
What you had
it,
on?
It was just a regular video. This was, like, before I even, like, had a bunch of followers. It was, like, when I had, like, 1,000 followers. I just posted some video, and they took my whole page down, and I appealed it, and they gave it back. But, I mean, you know, I was getting violations for nudity.
You was naked on that?
I wasn't naked. You know,
what you had on
that?
Was your nipples on that? You know, Myra got the hardest nipples in the county.
That's not
she got
true.
The hardest nipples in Broward Day in Palm Beach County. So it's tri-state area, the hardest nipples in South Florida right
Stop
now.
Stop it. No, but what that you said is true, though. Like, the other folks, they let them ride. Like, they be on there shaking their butt and everything.
Who be shaking their butt? Why y'all ain't sending
something?
The white girls. Is the butt moving or
they
just shaking? Is the back?
No, it's moving.
It be a little movement and stuff. Yeah, but we get on here, my nipples be hard, and you can see it through my clothes, and I'm getting violations and, you know.
And my page got violated a few times, and I appealed it, and they gave it back. Mm. They gave it back to me 3 times, and then they did it again, and they did not want to give it back to me because...
They probably looked at you like you still ain't learned.
No, but the thing is, someone reported my live, and they shut down everything for that. But then after I appealed it, and they looked at it, they gave it back. And then someone did it
they
again.
Just be
so
doing stuff
people was reporting my lives, and I was just like, why?
It.
Like, I don't be on
they
there
don't
doing
want you
nothing.
To be great. No. And
exactly.
The thing about TikTok, all you need is like one or two people to report you. That'll tell your whole shit up.
Exactly.
They don't even got to be like, no, I'm serious. They don't even do no investigation.
I feel like it was my ex-boyfriend.
You got banned before? You lost your account too? Before?
Oh, yeah. I lost one at 15,000, but now I got a new one. It's at 54, but okay. I don't really be posting on it no more because I'm scared.
Yeah, exactly. I was about to say, I'm literally like little posting.
You got
here
it, but
there.
It's like you scared you don't want to, you know what I'm saying? It's like some new shoes. Like, I got these hoes, but I can't wear them
yeah.
everywhere.
Yeah.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So I just have this whole account with 54,000 followers, and I'm like, okay.
I love TikTok. I will get on TikTok more than I get on Instagram. And when I'm on TikTok, I'm different. Like, I be liking people's
sound
stuff.
Different on
yeah.
that.
I comment. I interact with people.
I engage on it, huh?
I do what I'm supposed to
Who
do.
Are
but
you
on Instagram,
superhero
I'm, not,
on TikTok.
I'm not that friendly because, you know, they just so judgmental on Instagram.
For
and TikTok is more family. Like, it's just, it's more lit.
That's
and,
so
you know,
real.
The experience that you get on TikTok and Instagram is different. Like,
it's so different.
You learn a lot. Like, it's really different. Is Information
it,
spread
I don't mean to cut you off. Dutchess, is this camera recording right there?
It looks red. It looks that red dot up there.
That red dot up there?
Yeah, that red dot.
All right, I'm just making sure. You say so you feel at home on TikTok, basically what you're saying.
Yeah, like I'll be talking to they, people be like it be conversations in the comments. Yeah. It's like y'all so nice, y'all so sweet. They're so helpful.
The comments be funny too.
Yeah,
the comment section
arguing,
on TikTok is hilarious.
I be in the comments. I be sometimes I do too
oh, yeah,
much
we
in
know.
The comments.
Yeah. We know.
I be doing too much, and they be like, "Oh my you god, know? I used to watch your video when I was a kid." Oh, yeah. I got chill out. I be talking shit in them comments on TikTok. But
nah, let me tell y'all how he is.
Oh god,
I'll see a video on my For You page, and it'll be like a viral video. It'll be funny or whatever, mm-hmm. and I go to the comments, and he commented like 5 days
oh,
ago.
Oh god.
Head top. I'll be down there.
I'll be like, dang.
Hey, if you get a little too rowdy, I deleted my comment. I'm sorry, this shit getting a little too rowdy. This shit getting a little too rowdy, guys.
Leave it. No, leave it.
Well, I got my, on my end, like, my homies be in the comments, like, so sometimes you see the TikTok, I'd be like a little baddie little girl. Boom. What niggas do, go to the profile, go to Instagram, right? Go there, and then you know how people you follow, if they like the pictures, yeah, you see them. You see it. Mm-hmm. All it'd be the same old dudes liking all. I'm like, these niggas be on all the TikTok girl pictures, but this vibe, bro. On the comments, so in there heavy, real. Chilling, yeah. Like religiously. I'm like, bro, this man liking like 6-7 pics. Like, boom. I'm like, look at this. It made me not even want to like no pics no more.
Oh my god.
I just go about my business.
So do y'all? You
think? Do you think it's gonna get banned or not?
Nah.
No,
that's
just, yes, no.
We
know you hope so.
I don't even care at this point.
That Kodak, I hope so.
They stole money from me, and I'm looking to sue.
Okay, that means she wants y'all banned, but not until she get her coins.
Basically,
as soon as she get her money, that's that check clear.
I mean,
you're
yeah.
out of there. What you think, Minnie?
I hope not.
You hope not, it's but looking, what you think?
It looks though? It looks like it from the videos that I've been seeing, and it's really like that because TikTok information spread fast and. With Instagram is much more censored. It's really much more censored. Like the stuff that's going on in France, when you type it in on TikTok, you see all the protests, you see everything. You type it on Instagram, you don't see it. Like you really gotta dig for it. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why they like that. That's why they hate TikTok. But you learn a lot. Like I learned how to do a lot of stuff on there. But
true.
It's looking like they might ban it. I hope not.
TikTok got all the, like, that's where the shit go viral at first. It used to be like Twitter, but the shit go viral. First on TikTok. What it is, like my booty brown, my coochie pain, my booty hole brown. You seen that?
The rap.
You ain't seen the rap?
The rap, yeah.
You ain't seen that?
Yeah.
Not
we're gonna do a TikTok after with okay. that sound. But it'd be the sounds that go viral on there. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I mean?
Then,
like
yeah, Instagram is just TikTok 2.0. I already saw it on TikTok.
Yep.
I think it's gonna get banned though. Because I think it's gonna get banned because this is like the first time. Both parties, like the Democrats and Republicans,
agree together.
On some shit.
They came together.
The motherfuckers don't agree on nothing.
We ain't never see that a day in our
And they really agreeing on like a joint. Hey, let's get this up out of here.
Damn.
And so that's why I'm looking at it.
Information
like,
spreading.
See, they try to do it with the net neutrality. That's
what the
who? Net. The net. What if
that nutrition?
Thing? No,
Nutrigrain net. Bars.
What? Y'all know what I'm talking about, man. Google it. They tried to do it, but it was unsuccessful.
They try to do what?
Trump, they try to ban like the internet censorship. That's all it is.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And
yeah.
then TikTok. Mm. Trump.
Yeah, but there's ways around
that. We're supposed to be freedom of speech down, but hey, not too free.
Not too free. That's
getting too
TikTok
free,
is.
Man. Got my dog. She got a little meow meow, a little cat out. Y'all shut her down. She had a baby suit on it. It was what? Covered up. It was snugged away. We got nipples
yes, it was
and
fat,
friends.
But it wasn't showing.
We got Hershey kisses. Y'all wouldn't let the Hershey kisses live.
Wouldn't let the Hershey kisses.
Yeah, because it get a little cold in the room. Y'all
Hold
shut
up.
That
now,
down.
Now let's not forget about you guys that were doing the
that be
the
doing
prints.
The
with the great. They,
oh,
I remember
gyrating.
It was a point at TikTok. All you saw was guys in their prints.
Oh my god!
In gray sweatpants. They not wearing
that's
no drawers.
You looked at it twice, and the algorithm knew you wanted to see the meats. It fed you meats.
That shit was sexy.
Gray sweatpants meats. Who's your daddy show meets?
Dude,
meets.
They
meets.
Had a camera right there. What's up, baby?
POV.
How was your day? And all you see is meat. And it stay there. But y'all want to take my video down because my nipple is poking through the
shirt?
I'm cold.
Right?
It's cold
she
outside.
Said I'm hard. I'm cold.
And it's cold inside, too. It's cold all the time.
Oh, man. For Shout real. Out to everybody that's battling with something. Fat cats, hard nipples.
It's so natural. We can't help it that our nipples are hard and our cats are fat and yours are little and your nipples are little. Like, I can't help that.
My ass is fat. Like.
Well, that's how we first 15 minutes we in on it. Hard nipples and cats, guys. All right. So I'm pretty sure we all have like an ex here, right?
Ooh.
Like an ex just in general, like somebody we used to date. We all have exes.
An exfoliator?
I have a whole ex fiance.
It's a new year, so I don't think I have an ex.
They don't exist no more.
Yeah, they don't exist.
Delete it. You hit them with that
I
MIB
got too many
laser.
New games, so this is a new body.
Okay, yeah,
new
body, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's a new body. So a lot of times when you have exes, people be like, you look back and you say, how was I even attracted to someone like that, or you don't even find that person attracted after the fact.
Why
do you think, or have you ever felt that way? Do you have any ex that you're not attracted to anymore that you just like, ew, like I can't believe I did that. Like, are y'all in that space?
Almost all of them.
Almost all. Why does that happen? Yeah. You think for you?
Because I feel like they'd be putting on a show in the beginning, mm-hmm. and then they'd be, like, trickling out some of their personality, and then...
They put on a show, like, and they'd be tricking.
No, well, yeah, they'd be tricking and, like, trickling out, like their narcissism or whatever it is, and then once you see the full version, you're like, I don't even like this. This person kind of sucks.
They sold your dream.
Pretty much.
Pretty sold your dream.
Pretty much.
We all love dreams.
Yeah, no.
Dutch, I'm not a dreamer no more.
Why do you look at some of your exes and be like, I can't. Wow.
Maybe, and it's crazy because that's how I feel about my recent ex. I don't feel no bad feelings about my ex.
No malice.
I pray y'all doing great because I know y'all probably watch my boy shit, you know. So I pray y'all doing great. I pray everything's going your way. But I'm not attracted to them no more. It's like, I think I seen a picture or a video because, you know, my ex, he does, like, social media shit. Mm-hmm. And, like, I seen, you know.
He's a comedian.
It's specific,
comedian,
y'all.
And he actually... Let me not do
you don't want to do too much?
Yeah. Don't put it all out.
What city he in?
No, he don't live in the state. Damn, all right. Keep going. Wait. But, no, I seen a video of him. He got me blocked because, you know, he was in his feelings. But he got me blocked, and that's fine. But I seen a picture of him, and I was like, well, he look like he's doing good. And I was thinking, like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like.
How you seen him? You got a fence,
though? He just had my body type, you know?
Oh, okay.
He
yeah,
had
muscle.
My body type. That's
a little muscle, boy.
Man, I she love the muscle
if
daddies.
If a man got a muscle.
Ooh, yes.
She trying to tough.
Yes, I am. Yes,
muscle
like,
on muscle.
Honey, I'm not wrestling, huh? I was just like, what was I thinking? Like, this is just no. I wouldn't even like. I never chew my gum twice though because it never tastes better the second time.
You ain't spend the block.
No, I would never. I've never spent the block for none of my exes, and I never will.
Yeah.
And that is what it is.
Man, I drove around the block like 20,000 times for one day. Shit.
All right, so doing
ran out of gas.
She out there doing drive-by.
She out there circles and shit. Hey.
Ran out of gas, came back like.
Here she go, there she go, y'all. Here she go.
You be doing stakeouts? You did a stakeout, man.
I mean, I can't say I haven't.
We all did a stakeout before.
I honestly haven't.
You ain't never stick out a car.
I popped up in another city on my man because he wasn't talking to me for a little bit. And, you know, but he did it to me a few times anyway. Mm-hmm.
So I only did it one time.
I'm going to do it.
Yeah. Yeah.
But bigger
what you
and
do,
better.
I'm going to do it.
He did it three times, 20 times, and I did it once.
Mario, you got to ask me. You look at it and be like, man, what the hell?
Yeah, I do. It's and that, for me, it's just growth. Like, I'm not the same as when I was dealing with you. Mm. So, yeah, it's like
that
I was
part.
Disappointed in myself. Mm. But I forgave myself for it.
No, yes. Oh,
I forgave myself. I really, because I'm like.
Self-forgiveness
the
is
way,
key.
The things that I tolerated, the way I was treated, I was like, yeah, mm-hmm. I don't deserve that. I didn't deserve that. So
that's what's up.
That's real. It's grown woman shit.
Yeah, proud of you, man. Proud of all y'all. You know what I'm saying? Admitting to spending that block. Growth, apologize.
I don't block again. There is no spinning blocks
here.
All right, I'm not an op. You can't come spin this block. All right, stand on what you said and stay there. Mm-hmm. All
right, in the camera land with
L.
Period.
Major L.
Are they holding L?
Everybody put out an L for my exes.
There you go. Wow.
L.
Why am I the only one who do it that way?
L. You block too. Everybody block. If I don't mess with you no more, you block.
Yeah.
Friends and exes. Y'all
that's
a fact.
That's big facts.
That's crazy.
On your fence to seeing what I'm up to.
Mm-hmm. My exes, I got some of them that I'm like, okay, I don't know why I did that. But I do know why I did that, if that makes sense. Like, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? Sometimes yeah. When you're in the thick of it, mm-hmm. like you having a good time. But yeah. then when them feelings get gone and you sit back and look at the bigger picture, yeah. you be like, what the hell? Like, yeah. you know what I mean? Like,
where was I going with
this
you?
This person mm-hmm. had more cons than pros. Like, it was stressing me yeah. the hell out. So it'd be like
smoking
that.
Blunts like cigarettes.
It's wild, man. And then I feel like even with like, even if you go back and like, you know, some people just every once in a while you do a checkup, a wellness checkup on your exes. You're like, let me go see what such and such up to. Let me go see. You just do a check. Mm-hmm. And I can honestly say that, like, you know, at time, most of them have kind of, like, either fell off or their... That their significant other person they with now is, like, not on my level.
Downgrade.
They downgraded. Yeah. Now, but, you know, and that's just... I don't know. Maybe they could be funny or something or have a better personality. But that's just from the outside looking at...
Or nice,
just,
huge...
Yeah. I'm just looking at the package from the outside. Look, I ain't not the inside.
Or,
yeah,
or money.
Or money. Or money.
Shout like, out you know to what my mean? Ex.
So, uh-oh.
You dating her for money, ain't you? Anyway.
My ex, that got deep
real quick.
It got deep. She pointed like this. Your ex still be calling you. That's wild. Everyone, well, I get like a paragraph text message like maybe once or twice a year. Like late night, like yo, you been out drinking. I can't, like, I always think about, oh my God, I see you doing this.
Really?
I ran into such and such and it reminded me of, I'm like, yo, let this shit go.
Really?
Wrap this shit up.
Really?
And let it go.
Oh,
but
my
it be like that. I hit you with that little pair. I'm like, yo, this person still thinking about me. It's crazy.
Oh my you know God.
Just take your dignity text.
Write that thing up, baby.
Yeah, please do.
Put in your notes. This is why I love my notes app. Just go ahead and. Write how you feel. Nobody's gonna know.
Oh, right? Oh, that's like a little dear diary.
Mm.
In your own notes.
I journal, but yeah, in my notes.
Mm.
Yeah.
You know. Damn, that's crazy.
I don't do that. So I'll be scared somebody gonna actually see it.
Who gonna see it though?
Like, you never know. Shit could be hooked. True. We got these damn phones. The notes is on your phone and hooked to the computer.
True.
Right.
Facts.
Like, it hooked,
I'm going to go delete all my notes.
Yeah.
Just have a password everywhere.
Yeah,
go delete all my notes.
You just never know.
And make sure you have your Apple Find on and all that.
Something happened to you. Your family go through, read all your shit. You be like, damn.
Damn, I didn't know you was like this.
It might.
My people ain't got the password.
You got to have that one.
My brother got all my stuff. Like, yeah. I got a couple family members got my location. And a couple have like every password. Man. Anything pop off, just make sure, or something happen, just make sure my last Instagram picture ain't no dumb stuff. Because when everybody leave that love in the comment, it got to leave me something. You know what I'm saying? Don't let me be nothing dumb.
Yeah.
Like an ill ass reel that did poorly. Like, you know what I mean? They'd be like,
poorly after you pass.
Well, I'm saying what everybody want to say. You
okay.
You want that last photo to be something. You don't want to be a club flyer.
Fact.
Oh,
you know
okay.
What I mean?
Yep.
We've seen it now. Our favorite rapper or music, something happened. We'd be like, damn, this is what everybody comment on, huh?
You're right.
This is where we at.
Oh,
last
picture.
Yeah, this
is
where we at. This
is
what we got.
That's unfortunate.
Just flipping off with something. I don't know. Unfortunate.
Or with something with a crazy caption like, live fast, die young. Like, come on now. Don't post it.
Where's it like,
anybody can get it. Nothing ever happened to me. That'd be the caption.
Yeah.
Gone.
Like, fuck it, put that in. Put that hoe.
Wow, out of there.
That's fucked up.
So let's talk about real quick Miami. You know what I'm saying? I know we all are out of the college days, but spring break Miami and the cluster F.
The cluster.
It was of March. Now let me let y'all know we all live in South Florida. We all spend a lot of time in Miami, South Beach, Wynwood, Brickell, downtown, whatever. We down there.
Mm-hmm. It was outside, y'all.
Man,
it was
outside. It's a mixture of young people. People that still celebrate spring break that never took a college course, locals, and they turn Miami into just mayhem.
Yes.
It's just crazy. So what was your experience this year, past recent years, or just overall thoughts of that?
Well, it's my first year in Miami. I moved here, last July?
Where you moved from?
Brooklyn.
Okay.
So, like, we had a good time. Like, I wasn't really outside, but when I was, it was a great time. But the stuff I saw online once the sun went down,
yeah.
Nah, I'm not with it.
After 10.
Yeah. After really an 8, bitch.
Yeah, 8
o'clock. It's time to walk to the parking garage.
Time to change.
It get dark.
Time to go. We can get lit at home.
Mm-hmm.
But overall, it was fun. I loved it. It was a good time.
Ooh, child. Yeah, no, I've been in Florida almost 6 years this October, and I used to work at a tattoo shop right in South Beach, right across the street from that 7-Eleven, and I seen some shit out there. I haven't worked in a tattoo shop for a minute because I'm strictly private and mobile with it. But, I seen a police officer get ran over by a car. I seen people get shot. I seen people get jumped. I seen girls fight. That shit, that's why I don't, spring break, I don't go to South Beach. I don't do none of that. But this year, I mean, I spent it with y'all, of course, in Lost All Us.
Yeah, Fort Lauderdale. We had a good time. Good vibes.
We had fun. Twist on the Beach.
We played Twist on the Beach video coming soon.
You know, I took home the crown, even though this girl actually.
Don't spoil it for him. Don't spoil it for him.
Anyway. She's
about to go in deep already.
I was. But
flashback.
But I went to South Beach this weekend that just passed, and I was out there filming with some people in rollerblading, and it was crazy still. But they had a lot of police out there on bikes, on motorcycles, on carts, on scooters and shit, on everything. Cops was everywhere. So it's like, you wouldn't be able to do anything, you know, in the day or really at night, because they're clearing the beach out and you can't park certain areas in South Beach after a certain time. But yeah. It was pretty fun, though.
So you went rollerblading without us, honey. Did you get an invite to rollerblading?
No.
I didn't get an invite to rollerblading either. All right, just checking. Myra, how do you feel about South Beach?
Oh, my God.
Did you get an invite to rollerblading?
Yeah.
I did.
And wait, y'all. No, first of all, I was out there filming it, but y'all live in. I didn't
want
y'all. That's wild. Look,
she's trying to pull me closer. I'm pulling myself in.
It's a parade.
She don't even know where I stand.
Yet.
I don't know.
You're
just hanging
out. You in the crossfire. You just got to get the strays. Catching strays.
Damn.
No, you're not. Well, I want an invite next time. My rollerblades got rust on
them. When do y'all want
to
go?
Anytime next week. I'm going to Houston this weekend, and then when I get back, I'm lit.
What you doing in Houston?
Final Four, FAU, Florida Atlantic. Shout out to the Owls out there, man. Gang, gang. We had a hell of a time in New York. Sweet 16.
I'm going to go to Ebony Fit Week in Houston. What's up?
When is that?
It's in August.
I'm down.
It's in August. I just see
that. It's going to be beautiful. My goal this year, I want to crash. I'm not going to name drop. I want to crash at least one or two women's retreats.
So, he's you know a what I mean? Menace,
so
bro.
I want y'all at the retreats trying to really get y'all mental together. Uh-huh. And I just pop out that bitch in baby
and
oil and boxer briefs.
Oh, huh?
Really? And do what?
Just wait for somebody to fold. Wait for somebody to fold. Somebody going to fold. If it's 100 women on a retreat and I pop out there with the muscles oiled up.
The muscles.
Somebody is going to fold.
Okay.
Somebody will fold.
Somebody gonna fold.
Pool
side too.
It's a numbers game.
It is.
Do the slow motion with the glasses on.
I'm out there. Adjusting my package on purpose. Just a little dumb shit.
Make sure you get a
stretching. Look, doing groin stretch, hip thrusters. think about it, guys. I'm there.
They gonna get you up out of there.
Like, I had no idea.
I would love to see that. I could be your backup man and be like, no, that's just my retarded cousin. He's okay. I got you. We can do this.
That's wild. Yeah, that's my goal, though. All right, people at home, I'm just playing about the retreat. But Myra.
He knew he wasn't. He wasn't playing.
South Beach Experience, Miami in March. How you feeling? Spring break.
Well, I'm glad I
went. What's your take?
I went out there. Well, we went out there when, spring break just started. So it was safe. And then it got crazy.
It was safe. That was our first weekend before all the colleges.
Yeah, it was safe. So schools you didn't feel safe out there?
Yeah. It was cool. We went out there, and then it was a good time.
Yeah, it was safe. I got my toes sucked on South Beach. You know?
You did? Okay, I wasn't going to bring that up, but since
said it. Oh, my God, I'm jealous.
A random dude, we went out there to create content, guys. So I don't want y'all to be like, y'all still going out there spring break? We live here. We can go to the beach whenever we want to. Obviously. If people out there with family and kids, this is still a beach. Just because it's March and you on break don't mean the rest of Miami just got to adapt to what the hell y'all got going on. Like, you know what I'm saying?
You.
This is what we live at.
We
was out there and the guy was doing public interviews. And my cousin was in town from Bethune. And we look over. And a dude got two, three little piggies of Myra toes in his mouth, sucking them toes down. And he was recording it. And he looked at the camera and made sure he was in focus.
He took my camera. I didn't know that he was going to do that.
He
interviewed me. I did his interview. And then I did his friend interview. And then I put out the camera to vlog because, you know, I be vlogging. So I'm about to talk to the vlog. And he's like, oh, let me get this. And then he's all shaking the camera. I said, don't be shaking the vlog like that. You know,
stabilize.
They watch it. Stabilize. And then he's like, oh, I'm with a pretty dark skin. This mini Myra, this, that. Her feet is pretty. I want to suck her toes.
Damn.
He went down there. And I'm like, you go suck my toes for real? He's like, yeah, give me your feet. So I just gave him my foot. And he started sucking on my toes. Insert the clip.
Send me the clip. I might put that on there. I might put it on top of the pie. If you're looking at the visuals. Yeah.
Feel me? I would do anything for her. Stuff. I want to suck her toes.
You gonna suck my feet?
Yes. Come here. Give me your feet.
No! Yeah!
This camera on me?
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah! Oh, that's the energy that I need.
I'm a South Beach toe sucker. You don't know about me.
And I was just like, okay, I guess. She said she...
Fellas, y'all sucking toes? Ladies, too. Because I remember I had a girl on the podcast. And she said she sucked guys' toes.
I would suck my man toes.
Guys, y'all sucking toes? Ladies, are y'all sucking toes?
When you really like somebody, yeah. You want to put every inch of their body in your mouth.
Yeah, I would eat.
Y'all suck toes? Y'all suck toes? Dude, so.
I got to really like your ass.
And suck them toes?
Yeah.
Have you had a toe-sucking experience before?
I have, and I feel very mixed because I was like, at first my instinct was to kick him in the head, like, don't do that. But then, like, something came in my body, and I was like, you can maybe keep going. It was definitely me. Okay, I was like, you can keep going just on this one foot for 5 more minutes. Like, all right. Damn,
5 more minutes. Mm-hmm. Have you ever sucked a guy's toes?
I have.
Okay. Look how damn she looked.
Right. Think about it.
Was the toes
you give me flashbacks. No, they were not the girl.
Did you suck the toes for?
I haven't sucked nobody's toes before, but you got your toes sucked. Oh my God, yes. I've had my toes sucked while I was, having fun.
Right. That's what we're going to call it, fun.
And she was wrestling.
Fun dip.
She was wrestling.
I was, I was on my back too, so.
Okay.
My toes is in the mouth.
Multitask, yeah.
And that is like.
Stroke, toe, choke.
Yes. That's what I call it. Stroke, toe, choke. Yeah. I was getting choked.
Put that on a shirt.
I would design that bitch up for you today. Yeah. We making money. What's up?
Let me get you
honey,
with that.
That shit right there felt like I was on the moon. Mm. I don't know. Like it was weird. Like and I loved it and I want it again.
I'm happy.
You heard it here. She wants it again. Okay.
I hope this man don't bust on this door.
He is.
God damn it. Hold on, guys.
He looked right at us.
Hey.
You go park over there and then come knock on the door.
Boo.
You better shut off your power.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Wild time.
He said 10 seconds.
Okay.
All right, I'm back. That was Florida Power and Lights. I have a bad meter and he's here to change out my display.
Mira.
In the middle of the goddamn podcast.
Wow.
Man, what was he talking about?
Toes.
Man, this nigga pulled up in the heart. Oh, the toes.
Oh, I was talking about my toes getting sucked.
You was getting your toes sucked.
And it felt like I was on the moon and I was having a crazy orgasm. And all I remember was it just started raining. It was just like rain everywhere. And I was just like, why are we all wet? Like,
that's wild.
Like, it just started
take
raining.
Take the sheets to the cleaners. Unless they fit in your washing machine. Well, good for you.
Thank you.
Pleasant experience.
I can't wait to have that again because it's been a long time.
I would ask Myra. She just said we inserted the clip. Hopefully, if I remember to insert the toe sucking clip.
I mean, just insert the toe sucking clip on the regular,
I think that's the second time that ever happened to me, honestly.
In public?
No, that's the first time in public.
Oh, okay.
But I mean, the first time was obviously like Dutch's experience, but I didn't have all the splash water flowers
and the stroke and the toe.
I saw
somebody messaged your toe. You got to get calm for a little bit. It's almost like getting a pedicure. You're like, oh, a little jittery.
Yeah,
because
I'm very ticklish.
Right.
I'm very ticklish. You know, a baby's diapers and your feet is like this
in the air. Yeah.
That looks like it knocked them ankles loose a little bit. Let me see.
You cross them like that.
My feet like this, had it on the chest, was just admiring my feet. Some people really have a foot fetish, so he was just...
Put the feet right here. Stamp me with the feet.
Like yeah.
Then he just took my foot and just...
That shit's so sexy. Oh, my God. I really love that shit.
Yeah, but the one in public, that shit did nothing for me.
Epic.
It was an epic experience, but
epic,
it didn't do anything for me. It wasn't like, oh yeah.
We just had got out there to film too. I think we met up at the CBS.
Luckily for him,
I just got
out the shower, so my feet was still
fresh
tasting like
dusty.
Cocoa butter lotion. Mm. You know,
he lucky. He didn't get
them
sand
sandals.
Yet.
I had them sandals about 2 years. You know, they don't walk the streets and everything. But my feet, my body was clean.
There you go.
Have you sucked the guy's toes before?
Nah, but like I said, if I really like somebody, I want every inch of your body.
She's open, guys.
I don't know about the butt part, though.
When I'm married. Maybe when we're married.
What you mean about part?
I don't know about that booty.
You haven't eaten ass?
Booty munches. I don't know about
you,
that.
You never ate no ass?
I never ate booty before. Yeah,
dang. So
you ate ass before?
Yeah.
You did?
A whole lot.
Did you have his legs in the air? How?
Helicopter legs is what I like to call it.
Well, damn.
Helicopter. I can't put that in there.
It's just like 69. You just go down a little bit further. Mm-hmm. That's all.
That's it.
Balls, this is resting.
I ain't licking Gucci yet either.
Yeah,
lick that
yet?
Too.
Well, you got slices of levels. You got to hit that boom. It's like meatball Gucci butt.
Yeah.
It's like, you know what I'm saying? It's a ladder.
Yeah.
Meatballs, goose butt. Put that on a shirt.
Meatballs, goose butt.
We got two shirts coming, y'all.
Oh, my God.
No, I haven't. I will probably one day to my husband because I would love to get very, 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 very nasty.
Yeah. You got, sometimes you got to do shit and look at each other the next day and be like, I can't believe we did
this. And so I'll do it again.
And I love you.
Love you for this shit, girl. That's hilarious. Well, all right, let me. What? Let's suck the toes, huh?
He said suck the toes.
Yeah, I sucked the toe before. A toe or two. It's really important if you're going to be looking on toes, go. You got to get a pedicure and go get that pedicure with your girl. Because sometimes that paint be thrown on top of that. You got to see what's under that paint.
Yeah.
Because you know what I mean? She might have a whole green toenail, a Grinch toe up under there.
Yeah.
You got to go see about that.
Black.
You ain't going to see that on this. They throw that white on there. You think everything right.
Uh-huh. Who got white toes?
I do.
I'm just saying.
Uh-oh.
We got toes up. Put
them
on the camera.
Done together.
Can y'all get your foot up? Can I get a foot up? There it is. Bob. I got socks on, guys. So I'll get you next time.
We all with the whites.
Yeah. So
we all got white.
You got
toes.
That. And then.
Nah, I got French tip. Y'all got white.
Oh, yeah.
And as far as the Remy Wimmies.
Okay.
I've both parts have been partaken.
Oh.
Yeah.
So, wait.
She wants to circle around. Go ahead.
He got that boo.
We're about to wrap around.
Go ahead.
Say what you want to say.
Well, you said both parts has been taken apart. Wait, what you mean?
He got his booty ate.
Elaborate.
My
ears are open.
Yeah, it's happened before.
Really?
Yeah, it was dealing with them older women, right? Mm-hmm. Didn't even ask. Just went down in there and I was like, oh, hold on now. And then, once I relaxed and I was like, oh, this is wild. You know, it's always some older grown women.
Oh, this is wild.
Shout out to them older women. Caribbean women. Caribbean
women be old get you right.
And my gosh.
And then on top of that, but. You know, make sure you clean, make sure you groom, make sure you squeaky clean down there. And it is what it is.
I got a question.
And then hold on, let me say with that, you know, a lot of guys that are not comfortable with themselves, they'll be like, oh my God, this gay. Fellas, if it's a lady, it's a beautiful woman, like you with a woman, whatever y'all do together, that's what it is. Like, you know what I mean? Sometimes it might be one of y'all Women Crush Wednesday, having the time of her life back there. Mm-hmm. So just know. What's your question? What's your question, Myra?
I want to know what.
Go get in the mic with it. Get in the mic with it.
I want to know what compels a man, like what makes a man just take his thumb, suck it, stick it in her butt.
And put it in the butt.
Oh my God, that shit is so beautiful.
Pop it in the butt. Oh, this is
especially
the monetized.
Control it.
Well, I think the butt plug with the thumb upper roof. I was at karaoke one night and.
We still ain't making a karaoke.
And towards the end of the karaoke, you know the song's over, you can start giving shout-outs and saying different things. And I started basically put a thumb in her butt movement. So I just had,
what?
I said, everybody in here right now, put your thumbs in the air. And they didn't know what they was doing. They just put their thumbs in. I said, when you get home tonight, I said, you put that thumb in her butt. And I said, put a thumb in her butt. Put a thumb in her butt. Now everybody put your thumbs up, man. Just feel the power you have. That thumb up, you know what I mean? And then you look down.
You don't want my thumb in your butt.
That thumb won't kill me. Then you look down that little balloon knot. Looking
balloon
at
knot.
If you look at it, think about it. A butthole is a balloon knot.
Like.
Look at that balloon.
Like.
It'd be like this.
I don't be
y'all.
Seeing that nobody balloon knot.
It'd be just like that.
No, it'd be like.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Look down that balloon knot. and go ham on them, baby.
Oh God.
So I think that's what it is. First of all, you got to, but
you got to go around.
Consent is really important. So ask, or at least rub that little thumb on there and see how she reacting. See how she feeling, tensing up, blah, 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 yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Prep it.
Yeah, I put a thumb in the butt one time. The girl asked me why I ain't put something else in there. I was like, oh, I ain't my dad.
That's
my
usually dad. The preparation yeah. to like, okay, you know, it's about to happen.
I'm saving the butt for marriage, but you can put your thumb or tongue in there
saving and the go butt dumb in there. Oh, damn,
this is fine. She licked the mic. That's crazy.
Gotta take me home now.
Oh my goodness. Not take the old mic. All right, guys, we're back, man. We had a little intermission just now. This guy came out. And what did he replace?
The box, face of Amita.
The Amita box screen and tore all the power up, man. Shit is crazy. Shit, man. So we're here now. Is that a bird?
What is that?
Is that a bird?
I think that was a bird.
I was like,
this shit. Man, y'all didn't hear that. Y'all didn't hear that because
I thought I was high.
My editing gonna be so well on this, but
Nah, they gonna hear that.
They might hear. I got bird out front. I got parakeets and robins out front and shit. Listen, man. How do y'all feel?
Hungry.
Ditto. What would you eat right now if you could eat anything you want? I knew you were going
to
say something sexual.
I knew you were going
to
say
that. I knew it. I tried to hurry up and get in there. Don't say nothing sexual. I couldn't get it in. Couldn't fit it in there. You went
sorry,
so quick.
I'm hungry.
Yeah. What would you eat?
Some steak and potatoes.
Steak and potatoes.
Or a seafood boil bag.
A seafood boil bag.
Yeah.
Okay. I eat a crab cake with some fries and steamed broccoli right now. Two big crab cakes from G&M right in Baltimore. Had to get specific on it. That's the right name of the restaurant. Go ahead. What you eating right now, Marvin? Come on now. Rapid fire.
A chicken salad.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. I just wanted to say that. I want something good, though. That's
you done made a snorkel on the mic.
That steak and potatoes sound good.
What you gonna eat besides meat, Duchess?
Well, I'm vegan, so I don't eat meat.
I meant the dangling because you just said some D.
I suck. I'm sorry. Anyways, I don't know. Something good and vegan. I wouldn't mind some vegan Haitian food right now.
Vegan
some
Haitian food. Ooh, I could go for some Jamaican food.
Oh, I could put you on out there in Miami.
Dirt chicken. With the steamed cabbage.
With oxtail gravy on the rice.
Yeah, on the rice. Put that on the rice. And then I'm a fat ass, so I'm gonna do a beef patty, bright chicken patty or something on that too. So. I'm gonna go ahead and go, and then I'm gonna take a nap. I'm gonna need a nap after that one, girl.
Yeah, I'm not, cause I'm vegan, so.
Vegans don't take naps.
We don't take naps.
How y'all feel about the blue check, baby? You can buy a check, baby. You can buy a blue check on the gram. You can buy the blue checks on Twitter. You want to be verified?
On Twitter too.
Wow.
Now's your time. Twitter popped this shit off. Elon popped this shit off. How do y'all feel about the verifications?
It's getting to some people's head. I know some people personally who just got it done, and I know their head is a little big right now, and they forgot who got them their followers. But we won't talk about that.
Damn! Not forget where you came from.
Oh, so why she look at the camera? She said, mm-hmm.
"How you feel about the blue check?" That
I mean. I guess everybody got, you know, different strokes for different folks.
But how you feel, though? Don't be trying to talk about it. I'm trying to be cute and shit and beat around. How you feel?
I mean, it's like you're buying. It's like when people was buying a lot of fucking followers. Like, dude, we know you bought your followers. You only get.
Your likes not adding up.
You only got 100.
You can tell now the way Instagram, you know.
Yeah, true. Yeah, I'm about to say they do be playing because mine's been kind of like low with my fucking followers. But no, it's making people fake it till they make it. And I don't think that's really cool for people like me who's trying to put in work to actually earn a blue check. It's like, oh, I don't even care about a blue check no more. Everybody get that blue check. Right. Like, it don't even matter no more. But, I mean, I do don't like it for the people who did work hard for their blue check. And now there's people who got actual press release on them that
they got
actually
blue
got
check
the
credentials.
Yeah,
credentials. Google them and they pop up on Google.
Exactly.
Oh, you can Google them.
Not for stealing.
Exactly, you know, and have, like, multiple press release on them to where they earned that blue check, and now anybody who just, I mean, anybody can be Google, let's be honest, but you doing your little five view rap video.
I knew she's coming for somebody. She's coming for the local rappers, guys.
No, you and your
local rappers, guys.
I mean, I mean, let's Damn. Be real. Put in work. I mean, it's cool, I guess, but me personally, I wouldn't do it because I ain't about to fake that. I mean, come on, let's be real. Like, why? I mean, what is that blue check gonna do? I'm gonna have to pay for that blue check? Like, that's stupid. Like, I'm putting that towards some equipment. I'm putting that towards gas, hoe. Bills.
You paying for the blue check, Myra?
Nah, I'm not paying for it. I want to get mine out the mud.
Exactly. Yeah.
And then it's like, them offering that, now I got to do more research. More Every time work. I see a blue check or somebody with a blue check,
you got to tell
me. I got to go through that page and see what you
mean. I already had somebody say, oh, you paid for a blue check. But if you tap the shit, it tell you how long you had the blue check. Yeah, so if you just got that bitch in March,
it does,
you paid for that hoop. Yeah. So dude was like, they was arguing.
You're
they were like, nah, he got his since 2020. So I'm like, damn, that's crazy.
Yeah, I don't want no blue check.
Let me tell y'all the blue check, the history of the blue check. Years ago, I was trying to get verified, you know, having millions of subscribers, millions of views on YouTube and all these platforms. I'm like, damn, of course people making fake accounts, using my shit, re-uploading my shit. I'm like, I would love to get verified. Tried to get verified, wasn't happening. They was denying it. I'm seeing other creators like myself getting verified. And I'm reaching out to them like, yo, how did you do it? And here they go, hit me with this. Oh, you need 3 articles. You need to do this. That is bullshit. Like, you know what I mean? That might have worked for some people. I came with my articles. It ain't do nothing. It's really, for the most part, like, those people were with networks and had hired people that could do it for them that were in, like, media and different marketing people like that. So with me and how I got my blue check, the lady who created YouTube Black, it was me. And it was her. She worked for YouTube. And she sat down with 4 other channels. I was one of the channels. And we came up with the name YouTube Black. I know some people don't like the name, but that's what we came up with. It was some other things on the table. I'm not even going to say what they wanted to call it at first. I'll say that for another day. But we came up with that. And that's how YouTube works. You have 4 or 5 channels. You bring it to them. You create an idea. They take it to another 15 to 20 channels. Hey, guys, we have this idea. What do you think about it? And it goes to the masses until it's concrete.
Yeah.
And I was just in that first wave. So she ended up leaving YouTube and going to work for Facebook. So she's like, I'm not going to say her job position, but she's at Facebook, and Facebook is connected to Instagram. Yes. So I said, hey, boom. She's like, I work with Facebook. I want to get, we got this brand. I'm going to send you somebody. Here goes a creator, like, manager for Facebook. Here you go. And then I was like, okay, boom. I'm like, damn, she has this big position. It's connected. I've reached out to him like, hey, you think you can get me verified? Like, you know what I'm saying? You did? Yeah. She's like, yeah, I can do that, but why don't you ask your creative manager? I said, you're on top of my creative manager, and I know you longer. So she's like, let me see what I could do. I can't make any promises. Woke up the next morning, verified.
Aww,
but it's all about, that's how I pop. That's how I pop. But I ain't never lied to nobody. Tell nobody, no, you need 3 articles. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, so,
you,
and
just
people be like,
know,
yo,
the right
you
need person.
Nah, but I was talking to somebody when I was in Atlanta with all them creators. And he was like, he cheated to get his, I ain't even gonna put him out of it, but he said he cheated.
Article.
Nah, he dropped music. Like, he made a track and then put that he's an artist, and he did the article thing too. Like, he went on Google to claim the article and stuff. And that's how he got verified.
Yeah, it probably ways to buck the system. You know what I mean? But it's like that. But, you know, but I feel like with people paying for verification, like, my verification ain't going to be as lit no more. Because normally, like, when a verified dude hits you in your DM, it was like, ooh, a blue check in my DM. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was like, oh, he ain't rich now.
A little more attention.
Yeah, a little more attention. And when you verified, your shit popping to the top of the DM. So they can't even be like, oh, I ain't see your DM. Yes, you did, fam. Like, you seen my shit. Like, and that's just like with Twitter. Like, it's people who add you, people you follow, and it was people who verified. So I used to tweet Rihanna. And I'm like, she might not reply, but I know you see this. Because it's a verified account. Like, you know what I mean? So you want, I tweet Rihanna all the time. I tell her I love her, miss her, all kinds of
stuff. Oh, my God.
Call me. I'm trying to come back home. All kinds of stuff. This is years ago. I ain't trying to disrespect nobody, marriage or the family, but this is years ago. So it used to go like that. But ultimately right now, I think, you know, I'm not a pocket watcher. Pay for what you want. You want to get your account verified, you feel better doing that. If it helps push your content or whatever, do what you want to do. Like, people do dumb shit all the time. People go to the club and pop bottles, and the bottles are 500% priced over. $50 bottle in the liquor store, $1,000 bottle in the club.
Crazy.
That's what you do with your money. So if you want to buy a blue check on Twitter or Instagram, do it, but don't make it seem like you're better than somebody because you got that check.
Exactly.
So that's how I feel about it. Do whatever makes you happy with your money. I ain't judge nobody. I see people that blue, I'm like, oh, that blue check look good next to you. Like, you know what I mean? Give them a little gas. That make it feel good. You know, but I ain't going to give you a hard time, but a lot of people are looking down upon and giving people a hard time. But if you get that check and start acting different, like you better than, like we're less than, like we're peasants. Because as of next month, if you don't pay for Twitter Blue and you're verified, even if you're a celeb, they're taking it away. So I'm going to lose my blue check on Twitter.
Oh, wow.
Because I'm not going to pay for Twitter Blue. I'm just not. Yeah. Like, it's not. Yeah. It's, hey, one thing it never was. Was that serious?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
It was never that serious.
I'm not paying for that check. And I had that Twitter Blue check since like 2014, 15. So, but you know, it is what it is.
That's
man.
Crazy.
But the craziest part is people are going to be able to buy a blue check and initially, ultimately imitate you.
Yeah.
So they could steal your pictures and then just put a blue check next to it and it looks authentic.
That's crazy.
But
that
yeah, I'm not
crazy.
Paying no $15 for no blue check. Like, that's Netflix.
Right?
And I'm about to say, that's a subscription to watch some shows.
That's just the way they're advertising it, though. Like, oh, you get more reach. More people will see.
Why am I not getting that anyway?
Exactly.
I hate the algorithm,
yeah,
bro.
Like,
if people subscribe to me, sending my shit to them. Don't algorithm. Don't send it out to 10% of my people and see how I do with them and then send it to the masses after that. Send it to the people who hit that button to follow me. And that's on every platform.
That.
I
really yeah, they just that. Really money hungry. When it
money
comes
hungry, to man. Mm-hmm. Like, already and rich. Now- we're poor. Shit, man, y'all already rich.
Y'all really are.
Y'all are filthy Instagram. Filthy rich, bro. What? Why?
Y'all teamed up with Facebook. Why? Y'all even more rich.
That's why they're trying to take TikTok out the game.
Yeah.
Need them TikTokers and hip shakers.
Yeah, because you can blow up way easier.
But yeah, they're greedy. I don't like that. You know what they did? I had a partner manager with Instagram and Facebook, and once they announced the little blue check thing subscription, they took it away. So I had one meeting with that lady. Then I got another meeting. Oh, yeah, it was great working with you, but I won't be your manager anymore.
Yeah, they
and
be out there.
This subscription come out. Oh, you get access to like a real person, customer support. So
now
like,
you got to pay
so
for
you
the
took
help.
It, you took you it took from it, me.
Took it
for, and now you want me to pay
took it
for
you can pay for it. Right. They gave you a free sample. They gave you a look, it's like Chick-fil-A. Here, we go, one of these nuggets. Come on by.
Are you serious?
More nuggets. Get the real thing. Get a meal. Come get a meal.
Yeah,
don't
like,
just eat this nugget on this Q-tip.
What the fuck?
Not a Q-tip. What the hell is that? A toothpick.
Oh my gosh.
Have y'all ever had a whole face? Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Whole face?
A whole face.
Oh, absolutely.
I feel like I'm kind of in it.
Okay.
But I'm kind of getting out. I'm kind of like now out of it.
You got your one foot in, you got your one foot out, shake it all about.
I mean, I really want to be
put a toe in the water.
Woman, but like everybody's playing.
Yeah.
And I don't want to like waste all this fineness.
Right. You trying to give all the fineness to one person instead of dispersing it all. You sprinkling that bitch all over the place right now.
I haven't had sex in a minute.
Stop lying, man. Women always talk about they ain't had sex in a minute.
I had head, that don't count.
Did you come from it? Was he expecting
I
sex?
Oh, okay. I tried.
That's the worst. Like, you know what I'm saying? You go down there and bullshit gun. You're like, okay, maybe we should. Oh, no. Wait a minute, damn it.
My Rose is tired of me.
That Rose motor. She tried
to leave my
new motor.
I know, right?
That bitch, I'm
Rose
done.
Rose and blue a gasket. You had a whole fade, Myra?
Ooh.
No whole fade.
I have one. And I feel like it's too late for me to have one because
it ain't like, never too late.
No, you got to have one.
You got to have one.
On the internet, like, I'm kind of... like a little bit known, and then it's like,
yeah, that's like, true. Dudes don't got discretion. Dudes be talking more than the girls. Dudes be talking more than the girls.
You can do it on a low because I do it on a low. Matter of fact, nah, ain't no low. I ain't even trying to play like that. Because it's this one, like my homeboy told me, one of his homeboys, he said, man, I just want to fuck her so bad. Like, I don't even want to.
Nah, you didn't hear when he would knock you down?
Yeah, he just want to knock me down. I'm like, see, you got people like that. And he said, just to say that I slept with her. And I'm like, see?
Dang. And that be the dudes messing it up.
Mm-hmm.
I remember one time I was dating this girl and she was lesbian. And I know y'all gonna say at home, well, if she was dating you, she wasn't lesbian. Shut up. She was lesbian. She liked women. She was in relationships. And we had a little thing. You know what I'm saying? I kept it on the low. I ain't telling nobody. I said, between me and you. And we started as friends. Mm-hmm. We was just friends. It was cool. And we both going through something. And you know, you both down bad, going through a little breakup, hurt. And you just got that one person that's there to console you.
Mm-hmm.
But... once she knew that I wasn't letting the hat out of the bag, I was discreet. It was between me and you. Mm-hmm. Like, it was overly comfortable and it is. But then, ultimately, I ended up getting back with my ex. I spent the block. And then, but I spent the block because it was my fault. So, my ex ended up spending the block. So, it was my fault. She came and got me back. Came and got me up out of the... with the net, let me pick a little crab and fish up. Get your ass back in the house. Street lights on.
Oh my goodness.
So it was like that, but then you know she tried to find like another person like that, and this nigga did not keep that work. quiet. And she came to me like as a friend then, was just like distraught, like crying. Because you know, one thing about not everybody, I don't want y'all to try to counsel me. One thing about the community, LGBTQ community, I think I missed the letter, but y'all get it. Sometimes if you're a lesbian or if you're gay and you change your mind and you want to go back to being straight, they look down upon you. They be like, you sold out, or you're a traitor, or you're not one of us anymore. Yeah. And that's nuts.
What the fuck?
Like, it happens. It happens. They be like, you a sellout. You ain't real.
Yeah.
I've seen it. I'm like, and I didn't realize. I'm like, damn, like, they'll disown you. They're like, low-key, like, we not cool no more.
It's crazy.
You know, so.
Tight-knit community.
Yeah, man. So it was like that. But I had like a little phase as well. But with me, I don't know if it, I talked to like therapists about this before, and I have a hard time. Like I never been like a hookup culture type of guy. Like I like when a person like likes me or has feelings for me. Like, you know what I mean? I can't just like, right, I'm exactly. Like, hey, let me know when you get home safe. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't no hoe now. You ain't gonna just be rum dumbing me or treat me any kind of way.
Exactly.
But I just got manners and I'm polite. But you know what I'm saying? It just be like that. So I ain't never really got down with the having a team of some, because some girls have like, you got to have a roster. But with guys are knocking down everybody on their roster. Girls are use certain men for different things on their roster. Like he pays the bill, he buys the food. He like, you know, that don't mean you sleep with all them, but the guys just be like trying to, like, yeah, I got a roster. They don't even want to have a basketball, they want to have a football team. It'd be too crazy and then be broke. How you got a roster? You don't need no roster.
Right. Dudes do something like go smash everybody on a volleyball team.
Oh my God. Man.
Dudes love friend groups.
Let them girls run a train on you, fellas. We ain't judging you.
Oh God, no.
Jeez. Y'all just so messy. Like, if you slept with homegirl, why you going to the homegirl and her other homegirl? Like,
a lot of girls tell their business, though, and that's how it pop off. You tell the business, girl. You tell that girl your business how good it was, and it's over. Y'all know y'all only be friends for a year or two. Two years of friendship, and then y'all ain't got new friends.
This is why I talk to and try to talk to and get to know people from out of state, because I don't like drama. I don't like messy stuff. And yeah, only been like talking stages.
The whole phase is dangerous for women, though. I feel like when men can have a whole phase and then we'd be like, okay, we're ready to settle down. I feel like women have a whole phase and then they always be ready for a whole phase. And then if they suddenly be in seasons. And then so even as she had her whole phase, you wiped her up. Soon y'all break up, she ain't gonna be hurt. She gonna hit that Rolodex. She gonna be like, I got these dudes that been waiting for us to break up.
Oh,
am I lying? Have y'all been in a relationship and had multiple dudes been ready for y'all to fail and be waiting on y'all?
Yeah, the dudes, they be waiting. But especially when you bad, the fuck? And you get shit going for yourself when you a boss? Of course. Everybody wants that, but no one can usually handle that. So
see, I had my whole phase very young, like late teens. That's and then like that was it. So like I really got out all my system, and I've done some crazy shit. So I'm good.
See, my problem is like I don't be trying to deal with multiple people at one time. Yeah. I don't have the capacity for that. Like I'm a fucking real life lover girl. Like I want
see,
one
Drake,
person.
You're the female Drake.
I'm a certified lover girl. Like I want to be with one person. I want to do everything with
certified
one person.
Certified love girl.
Like,
and that's what I'm just saying. She says she ready to give it all. She ain't throwing no more sprinkling. Yeah. I'm ready to give it all.
Yeah, because I hate feel like I'm talking to people every single week. Like I'm talking to someone, I like them, I really want to get to know them. Then I have to cut them off. Okay, I meet someone new. Bang. Let's see where it's going. Cut them off. I end up meeting someone else. Like, I feel like I'm talking to someone new every week. So I'm like, in a way, that's how I consider my whole state. Because I feel like every fucking week or month, I'm talking to someone new. I'm not having sex with them.
Well, they ain't really a whole state. You know what I'm talking about, Damon. Don't sugarcoat.
Down there,
Hope, you said, go ahead. Well, that's the thing. Go ahead.
No, I don't like, I really like being intimate. I'm a very intimate person. So I really like care about that connection with the person that I'm being intimate with. Like, I really value that. You can't do that if you're just sleeping with this person, that person. Like, I'm not with that casual sex.
Yeah, they take a piece of soul.
Can I get a nice whisper on three? We're going to whisper intimacy in the mic. Nice, softly, and gently. Be nice and close. One, two, three.
Intimacy.
That was beautiful.
Thank you, everybody. I love
All right, so at the end, so you say, you know what I'm saying, you got your freaky stuff out of the way early. What was one of the freakiest things you ever did in general in the stage period?
Oh, here we go.
We're
gonna pop it. We're gonna cap this thing on right.
Way freakier as I got older, but like in that specific whole phase, probably a fivesome.
A fivesome orgy down, huh? Well, let her be. What's the ratio?
Shit. Three girls, two guys.
My guys. See, my thing is with that whole organization type of thing and a whole or like the training, because like, you know, guys always, women say, oh, guys try to shame threesomes if it's two guys and one girl, and they call it a train.
Mm-hmm.
And my thing is, I call it a train because a threesome is if it's two girls and a guy. And the girl's doing things too. Everybody doing things. Now if it's two guys and a girl, is the guys doing things? If not, they just tearing you to smithereens. Yeah. Like double team you. Like they want to train on you. So that's how I think about it like that. So, and that's not knocking that. Do whatever you like. Do what you like. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I love that for you. But as far as the other guys in the room, like two guys or even like a one guy, I'd be thrilled because I feel like as a man, I don't like being butt naked around other men, and, you know, like that, because I'm good on that. Like, you know what I mean? And like, even with the intimacy, I love the kid. I like all of that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so I don't want, you know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna slop dude up and come give me a kid. Yeah. Not back like that. Nah.
But people really be out here having sex and but some avoiding people kisses.
Yeah, I don't get that. That's whole stuff. Hoes know, like, not to kiss that dude. Like, you know, you're dealing with certain dude you ain't, like, that's up there. You know, oh, no, you probably won't let me kiss him in the monitor. But that's, like, higher up, like, treat, like, boom. That's, like, sex work type stuff. Like, we just here in it to split it. Like, but, like, if we sleeping together, there's no way, like, even a guy on my other podcast, he's like, oh, if she bad, I'll go down on her. If you don't want to go down on her, if she ain't bad, why you even sleep with her in general?
Right. Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so to be like that, so, you know what I'm saying? So, you got that. I'm trying to kiss. I don't know how people be sleeping together, not smooching. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's crazy. And I can't just be in the room with other dudes with, you know what I'm saying? They joint strong, my joint strong. And like, you're going to see each other. You're going to look at each other. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Try not to do eye contact.
Like, I'm don't good look on me. Him. All right, so real quick, we're gonna wrap it up, but go ahead, that's just the freakiest thing you ever done. We're gonna rapid fire. You thinking?
It'll have to be recent. I mean, I went to a swingers club.
My guy, love it.
And with one dude that I was kind of already like.
Did anybody partake?
It was just me and him. I don't do.
People watch? People watch?
Oh, yeah. They was loving me. They was loving me.
Let me know next time you guys go out there.
No. I would do
it. Can't that be like this? That's my dog. Get his ass. Get it.
I'm
going to
be over there holding her leg up. Yeah.
I'm going to have a sign. That's the
dad. I'm going to be holding her leg up. He's going to be.
Hey, I'm going to be out there like Tristan.
Fuck back.
Hey, y'all, and you know they kept surrounding us because I'm a squirter, and if you hit a certain spot, it like projects and it keeps going and it
raincoat,
keeps going.
Poncho.
Especially because I'll be hydrated too. I drink a lot of water, so
gotta stay hydrated.
But no one, I didn't touch nobody. But other than that, they were just like surrounding
little
us.
Little audience vibe.
Yeah, Mama, and that was my first time.
Yeah, this shit keep going up. Wow. It's getting up.
It's like when I hear other people's stories, I'm like, I ain't do nothing yet. Mm. No, compared to her, we ain't did shit.
Super afraid. Johnny Depp, Amber Heard.
Come on, Mara.
That was freaky.
I mean, the most spontaneous thing I ever did was just like have sex on top of the hood.
Okay, outside. You outside with it?
I've been outside in the woods, in the mall.
I don't know if anybody saw, but it was like a real thrill seeker.
Damn, I haven't tried that yet. That sounds fun.
Sex on a car? Because that was when I first got spat in my mouth, and I was like, I ain't know I like this nasty ass.
I know,
shit.
Right?
Oh, and then he told me to do it back, and then I did a little something. He was like, more. I said, oh, you dirty.
What's that, more? So he turned into somebody, more.
Wow.
He said some good soup.
Happy for y'all.
What's yours?
No, I ain't gonna leave y'all like that. I think I did like a little uh, like a little late night picnic, you know what I'm saying? And then it wasn't even planned by me. Like I had a girl, like, was in college. She wanted to throw a picnic for me, and we ended up doing it, like, you know what I'm saying, on the football field, like the practice field. I played ball, you know what I'm saying? But ultimately it was way more than a picnic. So the picnic was like the little, just the beginning. Mm-hmm. And then we ended up doing it outside on the field, in the middle of the football field.
I got a guy in a dugout one time.
A dugout?
Yeah, the baseball dugout. At a high school. Batter up, yeah, I took his you virginity.
You in the hole, damn.
Batter up.
Like, you on deck, you in the hole.
Batter up.
So that's I did funny. That. Of course, everybody hit the typical, you know what I'm saying, I-95. You know. In the car, by the car, on the highway, little highway action.
Oh, I need some road.
No, we move. I'm driving that bitch. Oh. You
What, hold up. She was on top of you or you was getting top?
Really?
Yeah.
She was on top of you?
Yeah.
I ain't never tried it. I was trying to see. I'm trying to see what that like right
gotta
there.
Gotta be a little risky.
I have too much ass on that
gotta
stairwell.
Gotta be risky.
Was she like skinny or big or?
Regular size.
She risking her. Man, regular size is different.
She ain't no seatbelt on. I had my seatbelt on.
Yes.
I had my seatbelt on, dog.
But she gonna fly out that window tonight.
Hey, look, man, everybody ain't gonna make it. Somebody gotta let her tell a story, man.
Oh, God, you stupid.
Make sure y'all follow the podcast on Instagram, man. Real Talk Pill Talk and TikTok. Real Talk Pill Talk, why it still stays around. Where can they find y'all at, Myra?
Y'all can find me at Mini Myra everywhere.
Everywhere.
Books,
Mini
Snapchat.
Myra.
Instagram. I don't even be on Snapchat. But yeah, everywhere. Right. TikTok and YouTube. Y'all
TikTok.
Tickety
you
talk.
Sound like me in the beginning.
Tickety talk.
Where they can find you at, Dutch?
Hey, you can find your girl Dutch, the Duchess, on all platforms, even YouTube, all that, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Beagle. You can
everything,
all
and I'm
that.
Tagging them on the gram on
Dutch,
everything too.
The Duchess, baby.
I tag them. Links in the description, guys. And yes. Last but not least.
You can find me on Bigo, Instagram, TikTok, at Coco Monroe, but it's spelled funny. So I'm going to spell it. It's COEXOE Monroe.
Okay. Yeah. Love it. Make sure y'all follow him up. Hold on. You still got OnlyFans?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Both of y'all got OnlyFans?
I do. Oh, no. I have a subscription on Instagram for my feed.
Okay. What you got going on the feed? You got to subscribe to figure it out. Oh, the feed. Oh, the feed on there.
Yeah,
she got the dolls on it. She twiggling all her toes like that. I know y'all couldn't see it. Them toes. Like, what you got going on? That's just on the fans.
I am dancing to my music because I am a music artist, and I'm also be doing more paintings.
Love it.
I will be doing freely paintings in my house. So just having a little fun.
Love it.
Solo action.
Hey. Solo action until things change. Never know, guys.
If I get a man, maybe.
Hey, you might get a little extra on that.
On me.
All right, we out of there, man. Appreciate y'all coming through. We love y'all like a play cousin. We out.
Thanks for listening to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast. See you soon.